रुक चार सही से रखना, देख हेडफोन सुन लो ना. अरे स्ट्रीम इज ऑन.
So the pilot, if the pilot has landed at a landing rate higher than 500 FPA, his or her pilot will be ejected and the corresponding aircraft will be submitted to undergo
treatment. This means
the pilot cannot fly the particular registration for a time of 48 hours. Yes or no? Okay.
Smart car as well as pilot.
Where is the mobile?
अभी डिस्कनेक्ट हो गया
मोस्ट
योर मोबाइल हो गया हो गया
हां स्मार्ट
कार और लाइक
बोलिए है ना है तो वाला रिजेक्ट ना और वो वाला रिजेक्ट ना है तो वो वाला मैंने कंपेयर करना है वो इस
व्हिच ग्रुप दिस इज
फ्रंट
मेरा है फ्रंट कैमरा सो
इज इट ओके स्टिल वी आर नॉट
Okay, I don't know if anyone else has had this problem. Indeed, me and a few more.
Okay, so coming back with you.
It's a wire, the wire.
Occasionally.
अरे इसका वायर
जल्दी
ना इस कैमरा दे हो गए मेरी गलती थी यार मैं भूल गया उसका बहुत इजी था तरीका ये नहीं है भाई कैमरा है कैमरे पे ये दूसरा लगेगा ही नहीं शिट अनूप
Need a website? Why not do it yourself? With Wix.com, you can create your own professional website. Choose from hundreds of templates. Drag and drop to create your site exactly the way you want. Change text, choose.
I get this dumb error. Press shutter release button again. I'm trying to take pictures. I'm doing this, nothing works. It's like something's been stuck. And when I don't know if you probably don't see, but when you look through the viewfinder, it's just dark. You know, it taps off. So there's something weird going on. So I looked around online, and I think I might have found how to fix it. We'll see how I try it here. So you're gonna press the button here on the camera, and then you're gonna twist the lens. Camera down here. So,
Say again. Zero is the most often cost in the experiment. But what scenario are we simulating?
We go virtual.
As far as I know,
we save fuel. We don't care about anything. We save fuel.
No. We have standard operating procedures, and we have to follow certain minimum.
It's between 5 to 35. Zero is when you lose working to get the option clarity.
You get it in the work,
path is already over.
The option is the option is
you need to split this field.
Talking about the percentage. Or maybe the normally the percentage should be at 25 or 25.
I will be mostly at 35, mark 7, 6, 7, 7.
More than enough.
Means too much. Yeah. I'm not planning to do a salary plan.
Feel happy maybe? It's too much?
Yeah. Probably you burn more fuel.
Yeah. Okay. So how do you request a roster from real ops? Okay. So now real ops is something which you will not get, what to say. If you want to fly, if you know that you're going to be free in the next app and you want to request for real ops duty, no, that is not going to happen. If you, this real ops dispatch request should be done at least 24 hours minimum of the desired time of flight. Am I clear?
Yes, sir, we are clear.
Yeah. So, at least at minimum of 24 hours advance of your desired flight time, you should request the roster. And okay, so now I'll give you a live demo of how to get this, get a request for dispatch. Okay, are you? Ready to make the link go
live? One second. Simple, banda padke le le. This discussion is not happening. You should have demonstrated it.
So the demonstration will be at minus 20 minutes.
Say again.
The demonstration will be at minus 20 minutes.
I don't want to ask. So this is having a dashboard. This is the dashboard and this is the UPC clock. I kind of thought that people are not able to convert the UPC time to ISP.
5 hours, 30 minutes.
Yeah, plus 5 hours and 30 minutes.
One more.
These are the steps which I given.
Yeah, okay.
So what are the reasons?
I think I gave a suggestion to put the Indian standard time as well over there for convenience.
Sure, I put the Indian standard time. Not an issue. Okay.
And is the date local or is the date UTC? Please.
It is UTC, GMT. GMT
UTC is the same.
Same. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I'm not asking, I'm informing you.
Okay. So this is the pilot details, and currently we are logged in with our events manager Hardik. His rank is first officer, his pilot ID is IGO 40.
Abhi, not now. We are launching in 10 minutes.
Current location is not fixed.
We will launch in 10 minutes.
So current location is not locked. And his GeoBox status is he's on roster. Okay, if something goes wrong and if you are not on roster, you will have a red color label over here which says not on roster. So these are the live flights. You see a live feed, the meeting over here. These are the live flights. Currently, two pilots are flying. One is Nakul and one is Adesh. So how to request a dispatch? So you go to the dashboard and there is something called as request duty. Go over that and you will see a form. So this is the form. You have to fill out this form. And there are a little rules which you need to keep in mind while filling out this form. Request duty only if you have enough time to fly the net. Okay? So I guess this is just a demonstration so I have a request. And again, like, you know, I'm really sick tonight. Pilot ID is, and this is the pilot name.
You can't give it to them.
I can't give it to them. So, one thing which you should follow the pilot name, some people like Ajit Singh Thal, Captain Ajit Singh Thal, he has a big name, and that whole name cannot fit into the OFP. You know, this pilot name is exactly going to be what I have to put in here. It will be reflected in the OFP. So, when you put a name over here, it will be directly reflected in the OFP. So, whatever name you want on the OFP, you need to put over here. And the pilot ID should be accurate as well. And you have ICAO, this is your hub. You know, I am from UL. Okay. Ajit sir, if you're watching this, we know you're on a layover, I'm sorry, you're on a quick turnaround to the buyback, Sharjah. But if you're watching this, you know, So your current location, this is something which you have to keep it in your memory. Your current location, it should be, for example, let's say your last flight was from VIDP. You'll have to put the departing arrival location of your current, you know, of your last flight. So the current location would be VIDP. Okay, so now we are doing a test run. So the day. So today is 3rd June. So according to the rules of the law, you cannot request the 3rd June. So only for 4th June I'm requesting. And if you are free for 3 hours, then select start and end time for 3 hours. You need minimum 2 hours of time to request a real of duty. That is, you need to prepare the aircraft and other stuff. We need to load the fuel, be as realistic as possible. So we need at least a minimum of 2 hours. So pilots who are requesting for rail loss, you need at least minimum of 2 hours or 2 hours and 30 minutes for you to get dispatched in a correct way. And so the start time. So the start time, I guess this is in 24 hour format. No, this is in 12 hour format. So you can use a 12 hour format itself. Currently the time is 2 o'clock. So 2 p.m. to the end time would be let's say 5 p.m. Or let's make it 6 p.m. And the number of legs in sense, see if you are free for 4 hours, let's say you are free for 4 hours and your correct location is VIDP and you select number of legs is like what you are requesting, but it is at a dispatcher's discretion to decide how many legs you should fly for a day. Okay. So if you are at VIP and you have free time for about 4 hours, the number of legs which you should naturally select would be 3. And the type of flight I guess, see, when you select out of next week 3, and you have 4 hours in hand.
Yes, sir.
Are we going to be following some sort of flagging time limit?
Say it.
Are we going to be following some sort of flagging time limit? Not necessarily the limit, but any specified limit. A person can't be flying like 20 hours a day.
No, this is, I'll explain. The start time and end time is the free time of the pilot. That
and correct me if I'm wrong, yeah. I'm probably wrong on this one. I think we're allowing 3 times a day for you.
No, I have about 20 times a day.
Real hours.
Yeah. You know,
yeah.
Still. In real life?
Talking about the pre-running, not as if someone is going to do
it.
So I get back.
What's that? Get back. It's cross-country. You want to
cross-country. So
you go, yeah.
I'm talking about commercial planning with people behind it.
Yeah, but I have seen people fly 3x over 4 offers already.
I myself am 7 to 10, so.
Yeah. So that's what we need to do. The pilot.
I'm not doing it. I'm asking you the real.
बहुत देखे थे रही मेरे वहाँ एकदम फिर
चलता है A quick turnaround means you return to your base. My base is UM, and if I select quick turnaround, no matter how many days I fly, I will return back to UM. Because it's a layover.
Quick turnaround is when the flight crew doesn't see you, the same flight crew operates, the flight crew returns. It's not necessary.
So now it's not a multi-cockpit view. Now it's it flies together. At the moment, it's not multi-cockpit view. So you're going to be the same person who's flying. Do you understand the point?
What I mean is, if you're based in Bombay and you do Delhi, Chandigarh, that doesn't mean, even if it's purely airplane, you land 30 minutes, you return 30 minutes, you go. It doesn't
it's
mean you track your base.
It's lunch break.
A quick turnaround does not mean that you will be
going to have any.
You
go and have lunch.
Is there any specific
for defining
that? It's only who you.
Jay, late are
you? Let's do
part 2,
okay? That guy, otherwise
you will go. But by saying that a quick turnaround is
guys, you go have lunch. Thank you.
So now to be a quick turnaround, so I will be returning back to base. And the pilot email.
Lunch break.
We face issues with the pilots. This is a mandatory thing, which